ahead, Chief.
Okay.
Okay, everyone, I'm gonna call the meeting of tonight, July 9th, Zoning and Land Regulation Committee to order. This is a work meeting, which means that the only testimony that we'll take is if one of the board members calls on you. So, first item on the agenda is public comment on any matter not listed on the agenda. And you'll have 5 minutes to speak. Does anybody have anything they'd like to say that's not listed? Okay, we'll move on. Before we go any further, we'll make introductions. First of all, I'm Chair Jerry Bollig. To my left is Supervisor Heidi Wegleitner. Our newest member is Supervisor Kristen Audette, Supervisor Steve Peters, and Supervisor Jason Canol. We have staff members here tonight. In the back of the room is Zoning and Land. What is your title? Zoning, Planning and Development Director Todd Violante. Zoning Administrator Roger Lane won't be with us tonight. We've got the Assistant Zoning Administrator Dan Everson, and we've got the Senior Planner Majid Allen, who's covering for Roger tonight. Again, this is a work meeting. Public hearings that have been held at previous meetings for the items that are on tonight's agenda. So the only testimony we'll take is if the board members call on or the supervisors call on you. When a petition is called, county staff will update the committee on the status of the petition, and then the committee members may have concerns or questions. If a zoning petition is acted upon, it will be placed on the next county board meeting agenda, which is July.
County board meets on Thursday, and any items that we...
Yeah, we don't have another meeting until August. So it'll be August 10th.
Maybe it's the 13th, or am I thinking of it? One meeting in August. Excuse me, 15th.
August 15th, so anything that we act upon tonight, zoning petitions will be acted on at the 13th, did you say, 15th?
15th of August.
15th of August. If a... a CUP is approved tonight, it's the final decision, and it doesn't go to the board. So the next ZLR committee meeting is two weeks from tonight, which will be the 23rd of July. So I guess we'll move on to the first item on the agenda, which is approval of minutes for June 11th and June 25th. If I could have a motion, please.
Move approval.
Second.
Second. We got a motion and a second. Are there any amendments or changes to those minutes that anybody would like to make or propose? Okay. Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Those minutes are approved. Next, we have a public hearing for zoning map amendments, conditional use permits, and ordinance amendments.
That's yours truly, mistake right there. Because it's not a hearing. And
oh,
we don't
okay.
have any hearing items. My
oh,
bad.
It's not a, yeah.
I'm sorry.
Okay. All right. So let's move on to petition 11408, which is Larry Donahue. Larry, are you here?
No, I'm at short. I'm representing.
Okay, yeah. We'll let you do that. All right. Is there anyone?
We don't even have to.
We move right
yeah,
on.
Yeah, no, we can
you,
go right into. I'll yeah. just give you an update. So this yeah. one was postponed. They found that there was an issue with, I think it was part of the soil that perked
right,
and they needed
right.
to add some additional lands to, you know, and they're adding, I think it's about an acre to the.
9/10 of an acre.
9/10 of an acre. So
okay.
it still fits within the same zoning category that was initially recommended. They're not adding any additional lot or anything of that nature. It's just simply amending the boundaries of the proposed lot to make it about 3 acres instead of 2. And the town has looked at this again and signed off on the amended
mm-hmm.
zoning district boundary.
Okay.
So staff would recommend approval with that amendment to the boundary of the zoning district.
Very good. And we have registered available for information is Ed Short. He's in the red red shirt there. Anyone have any questions for Ed? Hearing none, would anyone like to make a motion?
Move approval.
Second, please.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Any further discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Thanks for being here tonight, Ed.
Good, thank you. Stay cool.
You too. Next, we move on to Zurbachen Living Trust. Is there a spokesman here from them? Okay. And you're who?
I'm Brett Salsa.
Okay, Brett.
And Adam.
Are you Adam?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Go ahead.
So, sure. This item was referred back from the county board. We had overlooked some comments from the county highway staff regarding some recommended improvements to the County G and Spring Rose Road intersection based on anticipated increase in traffic volume. And so in your staff report, and I apologize that I'm not able to display it there, but there were two recommendations that Roger had outlined. And I've been in contact with the applicant and engineer, who had also been in contact with highway staff, and have come to the determination that that second option, where the approval is conditioned upon them entering into an agreement with the highway department to get the improvements done, I believe within a 2-year period, so they're in agreement with that based on the conversation or email exchange anyway that I had with them earlier. You can ask them that directly, I suppose.
You gentlemen are nodding your heads. I assume you're okay with that?
Yes.
Okay. How about the adjoining landowner? Is he still up in the air regarding this petition?
I talked to him, and he's okay. We're doing a prairie restoration and 25 acres there.
Okay. Well, he's not here tonight, so I assume he's doing okay. All right. So we're also...
It was 2 years from when the plat recorded.
I believe that's how it was worded in the staff report, yes.
2 years from the...
2 years of the recording of the subdivision plat.
Of the plat, right.
Okay. All right. And you don't have a problem with that?
No.
Okay. And then just to confirm, we also had some town conditions on that approval, so the recommendation would be to move with the town and staff recommendation for that second option.
Okay. Would someone like to make a motion regarding this petition?
So are we placing a condition on the petition and postponing the action?
No, this would be approving the petition contingent on those conditions.
Those conditions.
So town conditions that address stormwater management and so on, and then the condition regarding the highway improvements and entering into that contract to get it accomplished.
Then I move approval with the condition on the rezoning petition.
Both conditions, all the conditions.
Yeah, all the conditions.
Okay.
And second, please.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Any further questions or discussion on this item? Supervisor Wegler.
Thank you. So with the, maybe we can answer this. With the 2-year time frame, within 2 years of recording, do we not think there will be impacts within that 2 years? Is that just how long the development process takes, or? Because they seem like two different, quite different options. One is you get it done before you move forward, and one is we're giving you 2 years, and I want to know what happens in those 2 years, and why did that one address the highway department's concern?
Sure. And Highways has seen both of these mm-hmm. options, and we're fine with either approach. And I know there was some exchange between the engineer here in attendance tonight as with highway staff on, you know, right now traffic can go, you know, to Spring Rose and exit right out to 18151 directly versus being, you know, going south to the County G intersection. Although that's going to change in the future, where they're going to be installing a frontage road, and so there was a question about, are you going to see this full traffic volume exiting onto Highway G, you know, versus being split between the two options. And frankly, as a commuter, I think, yeah, folks, Spring Rose Road, if you've ever been out by 18151 and Maple Leaf Lawn Care, that's the term we're talking about. You probably see a fair number of people taking that direct route. Now, once that's closed off, and I don't know the timeline for that through DOT, in any case, the point being that between that issue that you've got now essentially two ways to get to this development, and the fact that in our experience, the build out of you know, plats like this does take some time. Not to say it's not a hot market out there, you know, and we have buyers for these lots, you know, lined up, but the installation, I don't know if you've got a phasing plan in mind or what you've anticipated for how this gets built out over time once the plat is recorded and so on, but you know, 2 years seems like a long time, but in our experience it's you know, goes pretty quickly, so I don't think that it's out of the realm of possibility. And honestly, I would defer to our, if Highways said, hey, you know, we need this done post haste, again, I had that conversation this morning, I hope they would have alerted me to that being a major concern.
Does that answer your question?
Yeah, I guess the other thing I would add is, you know, for the developer's part, you know, going and spending the funds and entering into that agreement without having the zoning approval secured, you've got this, you know, cart and horse, chicken and egg type of issue.
Mm-hmm.
Having the zoning approvals, knowing they're contingent on this getting accomplished, you know, gives them some certainty going forward, and as well for us, that these things will get accomplished.
Okay, any further questions? Okay, we've got a motion. Okay.
The town was concerned with the wetland delineation and report, and that's under the town condition would come to us as well as the town prior to the preliminary plat. And also a stormwater management plan to the town. So I guess should I be satisfied that those are sufficient at that point in the process? Is that typical?
Or? I would think so. Yeah. I mean, before they can disturb any ground, they have to have those approvals in place.
And
it'll be conditioned upon the subdivision plat being approved at this level too.
Mm-hmm. So that comes to us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The preliminary plat comes technically before you twice, and then the final plat technically comes before you twice as well, one for approval and then one for the signature. So
yeah, that we have that come forward to us every meeting.
And we don't necessarily need erosion control permits you know, in place prior to the chair of this committee signing off on the plat and recorded. It's just there's a condition before any dirt can be turned or, you know, any, you know, ground disturbed, they have to have those approvals in place at that time. So.
All right, further questions or comments? Okay, we have a motion on the floor to approve this petition with the town and staff conditions.
Second.
The option two.
Okay. So we've got a motion. I don't believe it's been seconded yet. It was. Got a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Gentlemen are all set. Next we have Tanner Medina. Rezone number 11429. Majid?
Sure. So this is just a follow-up cleanup petition to correct some errors in the zoning map based on what the staff had put together. So the town has reviewed all of these and signed off on them, and we would encourage your...
Okay. Any questions or comments from the committee? Can I have a motion from the committee, please?
Move approval.
Second.
And we got a motion and a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Next we have, I lost this. Plats and CSMs. Dan?
Yeah, this is in the Village of Windsor. Revere Trails, first edition. Got to chuckle just a little bit here, but this plat consists of 11 lots with two outlots and 26 acres. As far as parkland, they do show outlot 7 and 8, shown as open space and stormwater management. Doesn't say necessarily whether it's dedicated to the public or not. Major highways, you have State Highway 19 directly to the south. And DOT has very specific conditions that are already currently in place when this plat came through us, when it was in the town of Windsor. Drainage arrows are shown on the plat. Schools are established. This is just maybe about a few miles, 2 miles west of Sun Prairie. Stormwater easements are shown throughout the plat. Outlot 7 and 8 are reserved for stormwater management as well. Pretty much all the roads are already built. Davies Court would be the only new road that they would be installing. So this is before you for a certification of non-objection.
Motion, please, or questions?
Whatever you prefer. I'll certification, not objection.
And a second, please.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Any further discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. That's approved. And don't have any resolutions. We don't have an ordinance amendment. We do have one item requiring action. That's the site plan review for relocation of a farm residence on the Hewitt property.
Sure. So the county ordinance provides that if you have land that's zoned in the exclusive ag category, you can repair or replace an existing residence provided it's located within 100 feet of the existing residence. And in this case, they want to move it 130 feet away from the existing residence, actually closer to the road. I spoke to the applicant. The town is in support. Again, this is a modest change allowing these folks to rebuild the house. I will say, though, in the staff recommendation, it was normally we want to see that old house taken down within a certain period of time of the new house being built. The applicant is, again, petitioned to the town saying, well, we'd like to keep this as an accessory building. And we've done that on occasion. The applicant meets certain requirements like cutting off well and septic, removing all the trappings of a dwelling unit. So our recommendation, I guess, on this one, given that the town has indicated support for this, would be to approve with a condition that the house either be, the old house either be removed or converted to an accessory dwelling through a change of use permit to the satisfaction of the zoning administrator within 180 days. And I say 180, the recommendation was initially for 60. The timeline they're working on would have that 60 days falling essentially in the dead of winter. So their concern was a lot of times if they are going to take it down, the local fire company will come out, use it as, you know, practice essentially to take down a house. And doing that in the dead of winter would not be a very good idea.
And you've communicated with the property owner?
Yes.
About that?
And they're fine with it.
They're fine with it.
Yep.
Okay. Any questions or comments from the committee? We have a motion, please.
Move approval.
With the conditions?
Yep.
Okay. And a second? Okay. Got a motion and a second. Any further discussion on this item? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Reports to the committee, we've got CSMs.
Yeah, those are the ones that have been signed and recorded since the last time we met, the last work meeting. So
I don't have any.
Yeah, there's nothing in that file.
So, well, I'll share with you at the next meeting.
It's like, okay, I'm looking and going, it's a blank piece of paper.
There is a bunch of them, trust me.
Well, I knew there had to be.
There's got to be at least 12 or
All right, next meeting is going to work. Any other business authorized by law? Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. We are adjourned. Good job, everybody.